back with another video on easy math. As you can see on the screen, today we are going to discuss about condition of concurrency of three lines. I mean the condition of intersection of three lines. Okay, what should be the condition for three lines to intersect at a single point? What should be the condition? Okay, if three lines intersect each other, then the solution of any two lines should lie on the third line, right? The meaning of intersection of three lines means that the point at which any two lines intersect in those three lines, means first two, second two, third two, any two of the lines intersect, then the third line should also intersect at that point, right? Because for two lines, there will be just a single point of intersection. And if that single point of intersection does not satisfy the third equation, that means that it is not the point of concurrent. So, and those three lines are non-concurrent, right? So, if they are concurrent, they should pass, the third line should pass through the solution of the first two lines. Let these three equations be the equations of three straight lines. A1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. A2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. A3x plus b3y plus c3 is equal to 0. B three concurrent lines. Then the point of intersection of two lines must lie on the third line, right? As we discussed before. So point of intersection is, we discussed in previous video, that is B1 C2 minus B2 C1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1, which is the x coordinate, comma C1 A2 minus C2 A1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1, which is the y coordinate. And this point lies on the equation 3, right? So you can substitute x and y values. That means that A3 into B1 C2 minus B2 C1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1 plus B3 into C1 A2 minus C2 A1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1 plus C3 is equal to 0. As you can see, in first and second term, the denominators are equal, which are A1 B2 minus A2 B1. So multiply with A1 B2 minus A2 B1 on both sides. In the first term, A1 B2 minus A2 B1 in the denominator cancels out. So I'll get A3 into B1 C2 minus B2 C1 plus, similarly in second term also, denominator cancels out, B3 into C1 A2 minus C2 A1 and C3 into A1 B2 minus A2 B1 is equal to 0. Okay, what is this? How can we represent this? Or in which form is it is? Okay, if you know about determinants, a determinant can be expressed in this form, can be expanded to this form. A determinant can be expanded to this form. Okay, if you don't know about determinants, go check it out on the internet. This is the value or expansion of the determinant A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3 and C3. And determinant is denoted with lines. Denoted with line segments on both sides. It will be like line segments, or you can think like it is like absolute value functions. And the determinant of A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3 and C3. Should be equal to 0. This is the condition for concurrency of three lines. There is another condition also, that is, if three lines, let the three lines will be L1 identical to A1x plus B1y plus C1 is equal to 0. L2 identity is A2x plus B2y plus C2 is equal to 0. L3 identical to A3x plus B3y plus C3 is equal to 0. let these be three lines, then they are concurrent if some constants lambda 1, lambda 2 or and lambda 3 exist, which are not zero, such that lambda 1 into L1 plus lambda 2 into L2 plus lambda 3 into L3 is equal to 0. That means lambda into A1x plus B1y plus C1 plus lambda 2 into A2x plus B2y plus C2 plus lambda 3 into A3x plus B3y plus C3 should be 0. Then that means that those lines are concurrent. Now let's see an example on that. Okay. If the lines a minus b minus c x plus 2ay plus 2a is equal to 0, this is one line, comma 2bx plus b minus c minus a y plus 2b is equal to 0, and 2c plus 1x plus 2cy plus c minus a minus b a are concurrent. If these three lines are concurrent, then prove that either a plus b plus c is equal to 0 or a plus b plus c whole square plus 2a is equal to 0. We should prove that either of these is true. Okay, how to prove that? We should take the determinant and we should use properties of determinants to solve that. If you don't know what are the properties of determinants or how to solve determinants in variables, go check it out. First, if these lines are concurrent, then determinant of a minus b minus c 2a 2a 2b b minus c minus a 2b 2c plus 1 2c c minus a minus b is equal to 0. The value of the determinant should be 0. Okay. How to solve this equation? Okay, for solving this equation, you may think that here we have 2c plus 1, right? Instead of 2c plus 1, if we have 2c, just 2c, then it will be easy to solve that, right? So then, what can we do? There is a property of determinants, right? I am thinking that you have checked that. There is a property of determinants. That is, we can, means if there is a row, which is mentioned like sum of two elements. Each element in that row or column is mentioned as sum of two elements. Then you can divide the determinant into two determinants. Means here we have 2c plus 1, right? We can divide the determinant into two determinants. Where in first determinant you will have 2c and in second determinant we will have 1. But we can't do that for a single element. We should do that for a complete row or a complete column. So now let's take the third row. Let's apply that to the complete third row. Then you'll get determinant of a minus b minus c 2a 2a 2b b minus c minus a 2b 2c 2c and c minus a minus b. This is a determinant. Plus in the second determinant, first two rows would be same because we haven't changed them. And in the third row, we have divided the third row, right? So you'll get 1. And second element in the third row, we remain that same in the first determinant, right? So in second determinant, we should write 0. Similarly for third term, it will be 0 is equal to 0. The sum of these two determinants should be 0. And let's do some operations. Column and row operations. In our first determinant, let's use row operations. That is R1. Means the first row. First row becomes R1 plus R2 plus R3. There is also a property in determinants that we can add the rows. Add the rows or columns. So first row becomes R1 plus R2 plus R3. We are changing first row to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Means sum of three rows. And we are changing the third column in second matrix. We are changing the third column to C3 minus C2, means third column minus second column. Then the determinant becomes as follows. You'll get A plus B plus C and a plus b plus c and a plus b plus c. Three same terms in first column. You will get three same terms of a plus b plus c in the first row. And the remaining two rows, we haven't changed them, right? So they remains constant. They remains the same. And in the second determinant, we changed third column, right? First two columns will be the same. And third column, what have we changed that to? We changed that C3 minus C2, right? So first term becomes 2A minus 2A, 0. And the second term becomes 2B minus B minus C minus A, means 2B minus B plus A plus C, means A plus B plus C. And the last element becomes 0 minus 0, which is 0. So the two determinants will change to following determinants. But if you observe carefully, first determinant, we can't solve that still, right? So we'll apply two other operations. Those are C1 becomes C1 minus C3. We are changing C1 to C1 minus C3. And we are changing C2 to C2 minus C3. We are changing the C1 and C2. First two columns. And the second determinants, let's leave the same. And here if you observe carefully, these three are common, right? And indeterminants, if we want to take common, anything common from the determinant, we should take that from one row or one column. Just one row or one column. But if we take matrices, we should take it common from every element. Here from first row, we are taking A plus B plus C common. So you'll get 1, 1 and 1. Then C1 becomes C1 minus C3, right? Here you have 1. 1 minus 1, 0. And here 2B. 2B minus 2B, 0. 2C minus C minus A minus B. Means it becomes A plus B plus C. And in the second column, we also changed that to C2 minus C3, right? Means here we have 1. 1 minus 1, you will get 0. And B minus C minus A minus 2B, you will get negative A plus B plus C. And 2C minus C minus A minus B, you will get A plus B plus C. If you observe carefully now, in the first determinant, we can take A plus B plus C from the first column and A plus B plus C from the second column common, right? But in second determinant, we can take A plus B plus C common from the third column. So you will get A plus B plus C into determinant of A minus B minus A, 2A, 0, 2B, B minus C minus A, 1, 1, 0, 0. Okay, this is the way to solve determinants. That is, we should get at least two zeros in any of the row or column. Because if we take two zeros, then expanding of the determinant will become easy. I hope you know how to expand determinants. Then the two determinants becomes A plus B plus C whole cube into determinant of 0, 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 2B, 1, 1, C minus A minus B, plus A plus B plus C into, now let's expand the second determinant from third row. Let's expand by third row. How to expand determinants? For expanding determinants, if we take any row, we should multiply that element. We can write that like sum of the element in that row, any element in that row, into the cofactor of that element. Cofactor means if there is a 3x3 matrix or 3x3 determinant, then the cofactor is nothing but minus 1 power I plus j, where I means the number of row at which the element is present, into, then the cofactor of any element in a determinant is the I minus 1 whole power I plus j, where I means the in which row the element is present, plus j means the in which row, in which column the element is present. Minus 1 whole power I plus j into the determinant of the matrix obtained by deleting that row and column. Means here, if you take 1, we should delete that row and that column. Then you will get the square matrix, right? 2a 0, b minus c minus a 1. We should find the determinant of that. Determinant of 2 by 2 matrix is a simple one. It is just the product of diagonal element. But in other words, here 2a into 1, the product of first diagonal minus the product of second diagonal. And the order, you should maintain the order, if not the sign changes. First, you should multiply the first element with the last element. Means here the first element means a, I, j, where I means the column row number, j means the column number, right? We should take a11 into a22, a11 into a22 minus a12 into a21. Or if you take it like a, b, c and d, then it is ad minus bc. That is the value of the determinant, 2 by 2 determinant. And if we expand that, let's expand by third row. Then first, 1 into cofactor of that element. Here 1 is present in third row and first column, right? Means minus 1 4 power I plus j means here 3 plus 1. It is 2. It is 4. Minus 1 whole power 4 means it becomes positive 1. So we need to use positive sign. Into the cofactor of that element, that is 2a0 b minus c minus a 1, means 2a into 1 minus b minus c minus a into 0, which is 0. So you'll get 2a. And there is no need to expand the other two elements because they are just 0. You'll get zeros. So it becomes the following equation. Now we should also expand the second determinant. It is a simple one, right? Because first two are 0 if you take the first row. And we should expand by the third element. Means by 1. 1 into here, it is in first row and third column. Means minus 1 whole power 4 you should do. So it will become positive 1. 1 into 0, 1, 0 into 1, 0 minus 1 into minus 1. Means 0 minus of minus 1. Means it is 0 plus 1, 1. Means you will get the same. A plus b plus c whole cube into 1 plus a plus b plus c into 2a is equal to 0. If you take a plus b plus c common, then you will get a plus b plus c into a plus b plus c whole square plus 2a is equal to 0. Means either a plus b plus c should be 0 or a plus b plus c whole square plus 2a should be 0. If the given lines are concurrent, means the given lines in the question, then a plus b plus c should be 0 or a plus b plus c whole square plus 2a should be 0. Okay guys, this is for today's video. If you like the video or if you enjoy the video, subscribe to the channel and like this video for more awesome videos like this. And ring that bell icon. It notifies you when there is a new video.